So good morning everyone. As I have told, hopefully I'm audible to everyone. Okay. So as I have told, we are going to have introductory class on anatomy and biology of finfish. Okay. This is the course which is offered by the Department of Fisheries Resource Management. This credit hours of this course is 3, that is 2+1, 2 theory credits and 1 practical credits. Okay, so before, so now today we will see what are the content, what are the course content we are going to study under this course in this semester. So we'll see, first we will see the theory syllabus, then the practical. Okay, so in the theory we are going to study about the internal and external anatomy of the important group of finfishes. Then we will see the study of oral region and associated structure, then digestive system, then food and feeding habit of commercially important fishes, qualitative and quantitative methods of analysis of gut content. Then we will discuss the anatomical details of all the organ system. Okay, we will see the anatomy of the circulatory system in finfish, then anatomy of respiratory system, anatomy of nervous system, urogenital system, endocrine system, skeleton system, and the anatomy of different type of sensory organs. Okay, as I have told, this course name is anatomy and biology. So up to this, this is all covered as the anatomy part, means from study of external and internal anatomy to the detailed anatomy of all the systems. Okay, this is the part of anatomy, and from reproductive biology onwards we are going to study the biology. Okay, that is the breeding biology, then feeding behavior, we all study in this. Okay, so in the reproductive biology we will going to study about the different type of maturity stages, then the gonadosomatic indexes, ponderal index, fecundity, sex ratio, spawning, and the developmental biology of the important fishes. Okay, then we also study about the age and growth determination of fishes by direct as well as the indirect method. We will study, we will see the fish migration, what are the different type of migrations, and what are the significance of the migration, okay, in fishes, then tagging and marking of the fishes. So this is the whole content that we are going to study in this course. Okay, now the practical part. In the practical part, first we will see the study of internal organs. Okay, we will see all the anatomy of different organ systems like digestive system, respiratory, circulatory, urogenital system, nervous system, skeleton system, as well as endocrine system. Okay, उसके बाद फिर हम स्टडी करेंगे फूड एंड फीडिंग हैबिट ऑफ द फिशेज. सो उसमें वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी कैलकुलेट द गैस्ट्रोसोमैटिक इंडेक्स. ओके, देन वी विल आल्सो एनालाइज द गट कंटेंट, देन एस्टिमेशन ऑफ द एज एंड ग्रोथ ऑफ द फिशेज, classification of different maturity stages, then estimation of the fecundity, that is the gonadosomatic index, then developmental stages. We also will see the histological slides of the gonadal development, okay, different gonadal developmental stages, and about the tagging and marking, different type of tagging, biological, chemical, physical tagging and marking, we all see in the practical courses. Okay, so this is about the course content which we are going to study under the course anatomy and biology of finfishes. Okay, so today we will just have some introduction. First we will discuss what is anatomy, and then few topics which we have already had in the last semester under the course taxonomy of finfishes. Okay, so in the external anatomy we are going to study basically the physical appearance of the morphology. Okay, so we will see some of the, that will basically the revision that we had in the last semester. So we will see how. Okay, so the very first, before going in the detail, we have to understand what is anatomy. Okay, So the word anatomy, it is basically come from the Greek word anatom. Anatom means dissection. Okay, the anatom means dissection. Who is doing the annotation on the screen? Please remove it. Okay, don't annotate on screen, please. Okay, so the anatomy is a Greek is originated from the Greek word anatom. Anatom means dissection. Dissection means cut opening and seeing the internal organization of the tissue and the organ. Okay, so anatomy is basically a branch of biology which is concerned with the study of the structural organization of the organism and their different parts. Okay, so basically, if we talk about the living entity. What we talk about, if we talk about the multicellular organism like fish, fish is a multicellular organism. Okay, means the fish body is made up of several cells. Okay, so if we talk about a life start from a single cell, okay, so if we talk about the body organization, then we have to start from cell. Okay, there is a one type of cell, then this particular one type of differentiated cell is altogether form a tissue. Okay, then this different type of tissue form the organ. Okay, and then the different type of organ forms the organ system. So from cell, cell to tissue, tissue to organ, organ to organ system, then this one system is actually dedicated to perform a particular function. Okay, so in anatomy, what we actually study, the structural organization, which start from cell to tissue, tissue to organ, and organ to the organ system. Okay, and there are several type of organ system, okay, in vertebrates. Okay, so anyone can tell me how many type of organ systems are present in fishes or in vertebrates in general? Anyone can tell me the number of organ system? Anyone? I'm audible now.
Seven.
Seven. Okay. Any other number?
Hello.
Seven was told by?
I'm 11.
11. Okay. Then? Any other figure?
Twelve.
How much? How many?
11 or maybe 12.
11 or maybe
11, ma'am.
11. Okay, we'll see. Okay, so there is a three figures come. Someone told there is a seven organ system. One student told there is a 11 organ system, and another student told there may be 12 organ system. Okay, so now we will see how many organ systems are present in fishes. So before discussing about the organ system, we will first discuss about the macroscopic and microscopic anatomy. Okay, so this discipline of anatomy is divided into two, the macroscopic and the microscopic anatomy. So macroscopic anatomy means a gross anatomy where you can examine the animal's body using any unaided eyesight. So you can see the whole gross anatomy of the body by the naked eyes, or you can examine the superficial or the external anatomy. Okay, that known as a macroscopic anatomy. And then another one is the microscopic anatomy, which involve the use of the optical instruments like microscopes, okay, to study the organization of the tissue, so tissue structure, which is also known as a histology. Okay, so organization of the cell, organization of the tissue in the organ, okay, and the study of the cell. So that all comes under the microscopic anatomy. So in this course, we are going to study both. Okay, we are going to have we will going to study about the macroscopic anatomy as well as the microscopic anatomy. If I'm talking about the macroscopic anatomy, suppose if we are going to study the digestive anatomy or the digestive system of the fish, then what we will do, we will cut open the fish belly and then we will see where is the stomach, where is the intestine, then rectum, then anus, then digestive glands, esophagus, all those things we will observe. That all the, those observations will come under the macroscopic anatomy. Then suppose we have to see what are the tissue organization or the cellular organization or the organization of the epithelium cell in the intestine, in the stomach, okay, or in the rectum, or what is the cellular organization in the pancreatic tissue, okay, or in the liver. So that all histological examination, that all comes under the microscopic anatomy. So in this course, we are going to study both the macroscopic as well as the microscopic anatomy. Okay. Now we will see the different type of organ systems. Okay. So we'll start. We'll see from here how many organ systems are there. Some told 7, some told 11, and the 12. We'll see one by one. So the number one organ system if you talk about is the nervous system, okay? So nervous system is a system, okay, which regulates the function of the body and sends stimulus from the various sources. Means if a fish, there is several stimuli from the environment, external stimuli, as well as there are some stimuli which are within the body, okay? So the nervous system, it actually responds to the external as well as the internal stimuli. So how the organization of the nervous system is there in the fish, we will going to see that, and how the nervous system actually respond, okay, against the external and internal stimuli, we are also going to see that. Then the sensory system is also the all is actually the this system have several organs, okay? It is comprised of several organs that receive the stimulus from the external environment, okay? So like eye, ear, skin, okay? Or lateral line, these all are the sensory system. So one, number one, nervous system. Number two, sensory system. Now number three is the circulatory system. This is the system which is made up of several organs like heart, vessels, okay, blood vessels, in which it circulates, okay, it trans. The circulatory system actually have the peripheral tissue in the form of blood, okay? And what blood does? Blood used to transport the nutrient from the food, the oxygen from the gills and other substances throughout the body. And it also transport the waste, okay, to the certain organ like to the kidney or the gill for the excretion, okay? So third system is the circulatory system. Now the fourth one is the skeleton system. So skeleton system is basically the bony structure that gives the distinct body shape and a form, okay? And this structure protects the internal organs and it also helps in the locomotion of the organism. So now fifth organ system is muscular system. So muscular system is comprised of the strong tissue, okay, which is basically promote the movement and the locomotion. So in the muscular system, we are going to study the major muscles, okay, which are involved in the locomotion, okay, and which actually supports the body shape and structure, okay. So we are going to study the muscular system. Now the sixth one and the important organ system, that is the respiratory system. So in the respiratory system, it is composed of different organs that actually involve in the intake of the oxygen from the environment or from the water and release of the carbon dioxide and some other waste, okay? So in the fishes, the gill is associated with the intake of the oxygen from the water and the release of the carbon dioxide, okay? So we will also study about the respiratory system. Then, as I have told, someone told 7. So at least this slide says no. The we have means the vertebrates have more than 7 organ system. Okay, so now the digestive system, which is associated with the ingestion, digestion and absorption of the food material. Okay, then 8th one is the reproductive system. Our reproductive system is actually the reproductive system, or the capacity to reproduce, is the basic characteristic of a living being. If that is the main difference between the living and non-living, if anything that is able to reproduce, okay, that comes under the living entity. So in the reproductive system, we are going to study about the system, okay, which actually involve in the production of the offspring. Okay, now the excretory system. So excretory system is a system that helps in controlling the osmolarity and the volume of the blood and tissue fluid. Okay, and it basically help in excretion of the waste material. Okay, basically the nitrogenous waste to keep the homeostasis and balance the blood or the body fluid pH. Okay, so now the 10th system is the endocrine system. So endocrine system is basically made up of several endocrine glands that secretes the hormones, and these chemical messengers basically coordinate the several response to the external as well as the internal stimuli. Okay, so there are total 10 organ system. Okay, how many? 10 organ system. So we will see again one by one. The number one is the nervous system. Then number two is the sensory system. Then circulatory system. Number four is the skeletal system. Number five, muscular system. Number six, respiratory system. Number seven, digestive system. Number eight, reproductive system. Number nine, excretory system. And number 10, endocrine system. So in this course, we are going to study all these 10 organ system. Okay, the anatomy of these organ system. So as I have told, if you have seen in this, when I have shown you the syllabus, the very first point of the syllabus is to study the internal and external anatomy of important fin fishes. Okay. So here we had an introduction about the anatomy. What is anatomy? Types of anatomy. Then what are the different organ systems? We have already discussed. Now we will see some points on the external anatomy. Okay. So now the external anatomy of the fish. If I am talking about the body shape of the fish in general, majority of, otherwise there is a huge variation. If we talk about the any shape you just name, that shape of fish is available in the nature. Okay, but most of the fishes, okay, the very common body type in the fishes is the torpedo shape. Okay, so majority of the fishes, they are torpedo shape. Their body is perfectly streamlined. Okay, they have the streamlined body form. Why? Because this type of body form helps the fish to swim efficiently in the water, because fishes are the aquatic animals. They used to be in the water and they need to be continuously swimming. Okay, so for efficient swimming, this is streamlined torpedo shaped body helps, okay, to swim the fish continuously with minimum energy exertion. Okay, so the torpedo shape is basically a shape where head is pointed like this. Okay, and then the body is broaden, and when you move towards the tail, there is a tapering starts. Okay, so this is a typical torpedo shape. So this is a very common body form. Most of the fishes are of torpedo shape or the streamline. But as I have told, the fishes is a most diverse group of vertebrates. There are more than 33,000 fish species are are reported and many more are still to be reported. Okay, there is a huge diversity, and that diversity also exists in the form of body form. Okay, there are fishes which have very different and unique body forms. So we will see in the next slides what are those body forms. Okay. Just see, here are some of the other modified body forms. Actually, why there is a need, why there is a different type of body shapes exist in the fishes? Most of the reason is because of it's modified. They get modified from torpedo to the another shape, depend on their habitat, their habitat and their feeding behaviors and some other physiological factor. Okay, so here see, these are some of the different type of body shapes. The number one is the globiform fishes. The globiform fishes means they are the fishes which are basically of balloon shape or a round football shape. Okay, then the serpentine, the name suggests the snake like fishes. Then the thread like fishes. Okay, then strongly flattened fishes from the side, like butterfly fishes, then the flattened but greatly elongated, like ribbon fishes, then flattened from the top to the bottom, or the depressed fishes like the skates and rays. Okay, so we will see one of the examples of these different type of body shapes in the fishes. Here just see these three images. Okay, these are the representative of they are basically the puffer fishes. Okay, so they have the balloon or the ball like shape. Just see. Okay, so this is a globiform. Usually fishes are of torpedo shape, but there are different body shapes exist. This is one of the example of the fishes globiforms. Okay, now these are the fishes. This is the eels. Okay, anguilla and other. So these they are basically the fishes. Okay, but their appearance is like snake like the serpentine shape. Okay, so these are also serpentine body shape. Then these are the fishes which have thread like, okay, like spiny eel. This is Muster cymbalis armatus. Okay, so these are also some of the Muster cymbalis species. Okay, these are the fishes of the order Cymbranchiformes. Now the butterfly fish. Okay, this fish have a this fish is flattened from the side. Okay, so this is, and they, because of their very vivid and vibrant color, their common name is a butterfly fish. They are basically the marine fishes. Now here you see the ribbon fishes. They are flattened and very long, elongated. Okay, flattened but greatly elongated. Just see. Okay, this is one of the trachypetriforms, the ribbon fishes. This is also a very unusual or the modified body shape. Then this is the flattened from top to the bottom, like the skates. Okay, skates and rays. So these are some of the examples of the different different body shapes of the fishes. Means the most of the fishes are of torpedo shape, but there are different other types of body shapes are also present in the fishes that we have seen here, like globiformes, serpentine, flattened, elongated. Okay, we all have seen here. Now the symmetry. Okay, so if you talk about, as I have told, there is many variation in the body shape. Okay, we see the torpedo, the globiformes, then the serpentine like, thread like, ribbon like, okay, flattened, laterally flattened. We have seen various body forms in the fishes. Okay, but whatever the body forms, okay, if they are the symmetry of the fishes, is fishes are basically the body organization in the fishes is bilaterally symmetrical. Bilaterally symmetrical means if you cut the fish from the middle, okay, the left and the right half of the body is basically the mirror image of one other. Okay, so the fishes, what their body shape may varies, but their body symmetry is bilateral. Okay, if you cut the fish into the two halves, the left and right halves are basically mirror image of one another. And the tail, which is a very important or the integral part of the fish body, okay, it is have it have the function more than only as an appendages. Okay, then the fins like dorsal fin, pectoral fin, pelvic, anal, caudal, all these fins are the peripheral anatomical part in most of the fishes. Okay, so it was about the body shapes and the symmetry of the fishes. Now we will talk about the body covering. Okay, so there are two type of fishes if we consider about the presence or absence of the scales. There are some fishes which have the scales. There are some fishes which doesn't have the scales. Okay, but the skin is the outermost covering. All the fishes have the skin. The few have scale, few doesn't have the scale. Okay, so today we will discuss about the skin and the structure of the skin, in generalized structure of the skin in the fishes. Okay, and about the scale we will take in the next class. Okay, so today we will discuss about the skin. So as I have told, the fishes, their body is generally covered with the tough skin. Okay, and it continues with the entire body part. Even if you see the eye of the fish, the eye surface is covered by the transparent skin. Okay, so eye is basically covered with the transparent skin layer. And then as you have seen, suppose if you see the ornamental fishes, okay, or not only ornamental fishes, there is a different type of fishes. I have told more than 33 to 35,000 species. They all have the diverse coloration, the diverse pattern. Okay, some have bandage, some have spots. Okay, some have very colorful fins, some have a very colorful scale, some have the blotches or notch on the body. Okay, a different type of pigmentations and coloration is there. Okay, so this diverse coloration on the body of the fish is because it have many pigment cells on their skin. In their skin, okay. So the different type of pigment cells actually are responsible for various or diverse coloration in the fishes. And whenever you touch the fish, a very slimy coat, you get a very slippery appearance on the surface of the fish body. Now, that slippery appearance or the slimy coat is basically a mucus. Okay, so the skin of the fish have the mucus gland or the mucus cell that continuously secretes the mucus. Okay, now this and this continuous secretion of mucus is required to reduce the friction during the swimming. Okay, and then and this skin, it is as it is the outer covering of the body, the outer envelope of the body. So the skin in the fishes, like other vertebrates, is the very first line of defense against the diseases, okay, or the pathogens. So this is about the general characteristic of the skin, okay. And this skin, it actually provides the protection, okay. And it helps in the adjustment to the environmental factor and it influences the overall life or the survivability of the fish. Then it contains the sensory receptor. Okay, these sensory receptor which are present on the skin, it helps to respond against the external stimuli. Okay, or whatever happening in the surrounding of the fish, in the surrounding water of the fish, that actually a fish sense just by the sensory receptor which are present on the skin. Okay, as I have told, skin is the outermost covering. It is the first line of defense. Okay, it contains the respiratory receptor, so it basically help in the receive of the stimuli Okay, but the skin in the fishes also have the respiratory, excretory, as well as osmoregulatory function. Okay, so when we will study the respiratory system, then we will see how skin also have the respiratory function in some of these fishes. When we will go for the excretory system or the osmoregulatory system, then we'll also see how the fish help in the removal of the nitrogenous waste or maintenance of the homeostasis of the solute in the fish body. Okay, we will discuss in detail when we will discuss these respective organ system. Okay, then we will again see the function of the skin as a respiratory organ, the function of the skin as an excretory organ, and the function of the skin as a osmoregulatory organ. Now, the structure or anatomy of the skin in general in the fishes. Okay, so the skin of the fish, it have basically two layers. The uppermost or the outer layer is known as the epidermis, and the inner layer is known as a dermis or corium. Okay, so here we'll see the structure. So this is the vertical section of the fish skin. Here you can see this up to here, this is the epidermis or the outer layer. And from here to here, this is the dermis or the inner layer. So the epidermis have the topmost layer of the epidermis is basically the flattened cell and the mucus cell, which continuously secretes the mucus. Okay, because of that, there is a slime coating on the body of the fish, which is followed by some of the polygonal and the cystic cells. And in the basement, there is a basal polymer epithelial cells. Okay. Now comes the dermis, or the which has basically two sections. One is known as stratolexum, followed by the stratum compactum. So this stratum laxum have the pigment cells. Okay, because of this pigment cells, the fish body have different coloration. Okay, and this stratum compactum have the collagen fibers and the blood capillaries, which is followed by the subcutis and then the muscle. Okay, so this is the generalized structure of the fin fish skin, okay, which is made up of two layer, epidermis and dermis. Epidermis have a mucus cell, polygonal cystic cell, columellar basement cell. Then dermis have two zones, the stratum laxum and the stratum compactum. Stratum laxum have the pigment cell and the stratum compactum have the collagen fibers and the blood capillaries. Okay, so every one of you have seen the live fish, na? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, suppose when you see the fish, okay, then what you, the very first thing what you see about the color of the fish, मतलब कैसी दिखती है मछली आपको? अगर मैं गोल्ड फिश की बात करूँ तो वो ऑरेंज है, but in general जैसे रोहू है, कतला है, मृगल है, पुंटियस है, अगर आप उसको देखते हैं तो कैसी अपीयरेंस आती है? कैसी दिखती है वो? कैसा रंग लगता है मछली का?
सिल्वर कलर में।
It have some shiny appearance. ऐसा होता है ना, glassy shiny appearance होती है कि नहीं होती है? अब if you look at the fishes which have scales on their body, okay? अब जैसे कि आपकी, जैसे मैंने बोला आपकी IMCs हैं, Indian major carps हैं, कतला, रोहो, मृगल, और you can go for the exotic carps, the grass carp है, silver carp है, या आपका कॉमन कार्प है, और भी जितनी स्केल फिशेज है, वेन एवर यू सी वॉट यू फाइंड, यू फाउंड अ वेरी सिल्वरी शाइनी अपीयरेंस, इज इट? तो होता क्या है कि वेन यू सी दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस स्किन, दिस इज द वेरी, दिस ग्रीन कलर इज द वेरी आउटर मोस्ट लेयर और द एपिडर्मिस, ओके, एंड दिस स्मॉल ब्लैक डॉट्स, दे आर बेसिकली द म्यूकस, मीन्स म्यूकस सीक्रेटिंग सेल्स, ओके, and then or the mucus gland which secretes the mucus, followed by the scales. Okay, scales are also embedded in the skin. So below the scale, have you seen this blue color line which is mentioned as a guanine? Is it visible, na? This guanine, And then the innermost skin, that is the dermis, okay, skin layer dermis. So this guanin is basically a crystal which actually reflects the light. This guanin crystal is basically the photogenic crystal, and because of this photogenic crystal, this photogenic crystal actually causes glassy reflection, okay? Because of this reflection of the light, the fish scales appear shiny, okay? Just because of the presence of this photogenic crystals of guanin, okay? Which is just below the scales, okay? So this is about the generalized structure of the scale. So generalized structure of the scale. So for today's class, up to this, in next class we will discuss about the scales, different type of scales.